Well, guys, I'm in my hallway now. Upstairs, you can see I just took the stairs. And because before I'm going to tell you, this video goes about what is the best speaker I found on the 100 euro and even under 50 euro, because you can find them often under 50 euro in the Netherlands. And sometimes even for free, gratis, my friends, gratis. And that's why I'm making this video, because I always tell you that if you buy a set, I think if you, for example, have 1,000 euro, and you want to spend 1,000 euro for a set, for example, I think for the most part, you know, that set have to be 60-70% price your speakers. So if you have a 1,000 euro in your pocket, I think 600 to 700 euro have to be your speakers, and the rest of the money, that 1,000 is not much, but you can spend for an amplifier. You understand what I mean? And that amplifier from 300 euro will not make you happy. You understand what I mean? It will not be a clean sound. Most of the amps I tested secondhand, because I still talk about secondhand, my friends. If you buy new for 1,000 euro, forget the good sound. Forget a good sound. You will not find a good sound at the moment in the Netherlands or everywhere else in the world for 1,000 euro, a complete set. And the minimum set I'm talking about is just a amplifier without any source, so no CD player, and speakers. Because CD players, you can, for the time being, you can play with a very cheap CD player until you have more money to upgrade that CD player. You understand? So a CD player you can find now 10-15 euro second hand. You understand? So I will not count CD player. Tuner, well, most of you people play with your tablet, streaming your music through tablet or Chromecast audio. I made a video from Chromecast audio. You can connect behind your amplifier, so you can place any source tuner from your mobile device or from your laptop, you understand? Or you can play your Flux from your laptop or your mobile device through that Chromecast audio. So I do not calculate any other source, only a amplifier and speakers. And to be honest, in my experience, a good amplifier, yes, what will make you happy, what can make you happy till the rest of your life, is when you invest about 400 euro second hand. You know, all those amplifiers I tested under that 400 euro. Some can come close. You know, you can find amps from 200 euro or receivers from 200 to 300 euro, what can come close, you know. But to be optimal, satisfied with sound, you need 500 for a good amp, 400 to 500 for a very good amp, you know. I'm not talking about those, you know, those guys who want to, who are able, you know. I'm able to spend 5,000 euro for an amp, but who wants to spend 5,000 for an amp, you know? And I am not that one. I started this hobby, well, I'm a budget guy, my friends. I'm a budget guy, and I have this expensive table. I will give you an example. I have this expensive table downstairs, where my laptop is standing on. That was really an expensive table. But yeah, I bought this table now, the smaller version, also from glass, with these legs. You can see them now. Let me take one out. You can see what I mean. These are leather legs. These are the legs from the table. And that's because the table downstairs is still beautiful, and it matches my salon table, so the living room table. It's a match, it's a dining table, and I use it as my, well, laptop table, but it's too big for a laptop, and I want more space for speakers. I want more speakers in my room, my friends. So I need the space in my room, so I decided to, I hope I can sell it, you know. But, you know, second hand, you will not get much for in return. I know this, so I will lose some cash. But I had to make some decisions in my house. You understand? And don't worry. The video started with what is the best speaker below 100 euro. What I discovered so far. You know, that all can change in a few years. Even a few weeks. You understand? But so far, 7 years. In 7 years of hunting audio equipment. And that part still will come, but first I will make an introduction and about something else. And so I will change that table, that big table that is 1.80 meters, so 180 centimeters wide. And I'm gonna change it in 90 centimeters, that table in the corner over there. 90 centimeters wide, so I have an extra 90 centimeters profit. 90 centimeters is a lot. I can place two extra speakers. You understand what I mean? And now I can only have three pairs of speakers, so I can place four pairs of speakers for my reviews, etc., etc. And what I also will change in my living room is my television now is on the side of my living room, and I hardly watch television, but that thing I don't want to place on the wall. You know, when I'm filming my speakers, you will see me reflecting in that all the time in the television. And a television nowadays, I wanted to buy a 65 inch. What's the 650 euro? You have a good quality 65-inch television at the moment. So, and then I discovered. I already last 2 years I was hunting for, or not hunting, but looking for a beamer. But those beamers, I wanted a LED beamer. I didn't want that old system, that DPL system. And now I finally discovered that there is a new beamer, a Chinese beamer in town. And that's a that's a full, so real HD beamer, LED beamer, and only for the price of around 260-270 euro, my friends. So, and then I can have in my small living room a 106 inch big screen, 106 inch in my small living room, and I only watch sports, football. That would be like you sitting in the stadium when you have 106 inch. Okay, more about that when I still didn't make up my mind. You know, I'm slow thinking with buying. I'm always slow thinking buying new stuff, secondhand stuff. I'm quickly convinced of the price. My latest score is, as you can see over here, these are really, I don't know if you recognize these speakers, you know, probably not. They are from the end, the 60s, I think these are the 60s, maybe early 70s. These are B&O, let me show you, B&O. They are mint, model M, or type M, B&O, very lightweight speakers, together with this, well, I'm not sure what it is. I still don't know what it is, because this was the deal I had. I picked this up 2 days ago, yesterday. And the deal was, I saw these speakers gratis, pick up for free. So I called the person, or no, I sent the person a message through through a mark Dutch eBay, and I asked the person, "You also have the I want these speakers, but because it was 5 kilometers driving, just close to my house. I want to pick up these speakers, just curious, you know." And I asked this woman, or man, not sure, but who I had, I think I, the woman from the house. And I asked her, "Is the radio also still available?" And then she told me, "Well, my son is selling it, and he promised it to the neighbor." So I thought, well, I told her, "I want to give some money for the complete set. I don't want it for free." And then she told me, "Okay, I have to ask my son in how far he promised that tuner to the neighbor." And then she mailed me back, "You can pick them up both, but you have to give some pocket money to the guy, you know, to her son, to the sales guy." And I thought, okay, I picked this thing up, and I really didn't know what kind of, because she didn't told me the type, what kind of B&O, but I expected a much older device than this one. I expected those wooden B&Os from the 60s. And I had €20 in my pocket. I thought, okay, I'll give the guy €20. And I will tell you that this stuff isn't worth more as 20, €25. So I didn't bought it to make money, you know. I bought it because I was curious. I didn't bought it because I thought, well, these speakers can replace my speakers because they are better sounding. That was my first, this is how my hobby started. Better. But I'm curious, my friends. I'm all the time curious about, even if I know in advance that this stuff cannot match the stuff I have now, I am curious how it sounds, how it looks, how it feels. You understand? And for €20, well, I'll be honest, just skip one time that restaurant and you have this complete set. This cheap the Netherlands is, and the speakers were for free. So I paid for the set €20 to make the guy happy. And the guy, the little guy, when I came in that house, he started to explain me how this thing works. He said, "Okay, but when you want to earn your €20, because I already gave him the €20, you have to help me with one of those speakers to my car." And the guy was so happy, the little guy. I think he was 7 years old, or 7 or 8. And this is how I scored this set. And I hope it all works. According to them, it still works, so I will make a video from it. And because there are always people who want to see this old B&O stuff, Bang & Olufsen. Anyway, my living room, or my stereo room. Here in my stereo room, as you can see, I have these Castle. God, let me see, what's the brand of these speakers? Let me see, what's the brand exactly, not sure. Yes. Castle Severn speakers I have here. I don't know if you have enough light. Castle Severn, yes. I cannot place them on each other because they have spikes. And as you can see, my stereo room is a mess, my friends. Again, it is a big mess. And what you see over here, this story, yeah, this Kenwood set, something, well, maybe I can sell it. Well, I will review it anyway. It is a 6-disc player, 6-disc changer, a mini set or a MIDI set, and one of my neighbors, two sisters living together in my apartment block. They always see me with stereo, and then they ask me, "I have a Technics, silver Technics set. Technics, this is Kenwood, but they talked about Technics." I thought, well, maybe I'm lucky. Maybe there's a maybe there is a SL1200 turntable between, you know, L1210 between. You never know, you know. And I said, yeah, of course I'm interested. And then I ring on the door and I saw this stuff, and I immediately thought, well, this is not the stuff I want, not even for free. But then in the I thought quickly. I said, "Oh, this is nice stuff," you know, because I didn't want to, you know, disappoint these two women, these two sisters, and because they waited for me for a month, a whole month, between the question they asked, "Are you interested?" and the moment I picked up this set. I said, "Oh well, this is a very nice set. It will make me, it makes me happy, because you know, now it is in my room and I don't know what to do with it. Well, I will review it anyway to test it out for sound, because I am curious. But I already know, almost already know for sure that this set will not sound nice, you know. But I didn't want to disappoint these two ladies that they could not make me happy, because if I would not have taken it, they would brought it to a thrift store for free, you understand? So I told them, "Well, this is a very nice set, thank you very much. It comes with remote control, and I will make a video from it, because I want to have this thing from my stereo room. Doesn't fit at all in my collection. And I want to make space, so I try to sell stuff. I didn't sold anything in the last 5 months, didn't sold nothing, 6 months, maybe one or two pieces, not sure. But if I sold something, it was one or two pieces, not remember. Oh, look over there, I have that. Well, this is a Sansui AUX05. I already have this thing for long time, my friends. And Akai AM57, yes. I gave that Akai AM55 to my nephew, and this one I have a matching tuner, a matching turntable, a Luxman Air 1050. This is a mint set GVC. I have Marantz model 2238 in black. I scored that one for €25, my friends, €25 in black, and that SR 1000 or 4010, and my Akai AM over there on the AM 2800 with the matching tuner, and some stuff below, some stuff over there. You all know my stuff, my regular viewers know my stuff. I think in this room at the moment, the top of the line amplifier is that AM2800 over there, that Akai. That is the top of the line amplifier. Oh, and those two Luxmans, I have two of them, Luxman Air1500. I have two of them, those are the two top of the line. I have four reel-to-reel decks. And top of the line is this 635D. Yeah, I have on top over there, I have one. I have this same, this is a DB, I have the D. Downstairs in my living room under that table, I have to review it. And here this is, well, let me move my speakers. This one I bought cheap, my friends, this one, oh, this is heavy stuff, I cannot move it with one hand, this is heavy stuff, my friends, heavy stuff. And then I have more. I have a Teac reel-to-reel deck over there, somewhere between that stuff. But this is the top of the line, my best tape deck, the 635, you know. This is my best turntable, the Pioneer PL1000. Yeah, Pioneer PL1000 over here, you know, below the booklets. Yeah, my friends, I have some stuff. And oh, this I have to make a video to sell it, the Amkron set. Yeah, my friends, I bought this last year. I still have to make a video from it. What is this? Oh, these are my reserve tweeters, because I blew up my Canton tweeters and I bought two pair. And all these speakers I have to sell and review them first over there. Some small B&O speakers, those black ones on top. Yeah, I have some stuff, my friends, I have some stuff, don't worry, I have some stuff to film, because all this stuff I didn't film yet, I didn't put it on video yet. Nothing from that. Nothing what you see over here I put on video yet. But okay. The question was, what was the best speaker? Well, let me close the lights. And I go downstairs. Let me close the lights. Yeah. To finish this conversation. So, I'm back in my living room. And as you can see, this is what I have in my living room. This is the other tape deck, the reel-to-reel deck under my table. The 630, yeah, I have to review it. And my living room is a mess. And this is what my daughter brought today for me. She brought some Chinese for me. And I eat this whole thing, you know, in one time. This is how much I eat. This is my problem. I eat too much. Normal people can split this amount between two people. Normal eating people, but I eat it in one time. This is my big problem, my friends. So she brought it this afternoon, and I eat everything. I still didn't clean my table yet. And this is what I want to change. You see this big table over here, where my laptop is standing on. I want to remove this table because it is too big. I want a smaller table to have extra place for an extra pair of speakers. And there is my television. This is not a place for a television, my friends. Not a place at all. So I will place a beamer, and that beamer will be the whole wall it will fill, I think, above my speakers. I calculated it with my centimeter, and it will that complete space between those two speakers, exactly between those two speakers, 106 inches, my friends, full HD for only €260. That's what I'm not sure if I, because I'm not a guy who buy quick, you know. I always think long if I want, because these pieces in the shops, you know, I don't understand when some persons, if they see something, they want to buy it immediately, understand, to spend the money immediately. Think about it for a week. Well, I think about it for, I think, 1, 2, 3 months. This is how I am, you know. I'm still looking for a better solution. Maybe I find a better beamer for a better price, you understand, or a little bit more, but a better one than I have in my mind at the moment. So I take my time, 1, 2, or 3 months. I take my time before I order the thing, you understand. AliExpress, I will buy it at AliExpress. And I still have I made a video. I had some Chinese people, firms wanted to do business with me, so I review some stuff for them, and I got the stuff for free. I have the box over there under my table, and I have a few things over here, and already 1 year in my house, almost 1 year, and I still didn't review them, still in the box, because when I got the stuff, I thought, well, this stuff, you know, I'm not sure. They didn't even open the box to check it out what it is exactly. But, you know, I have two speakers over there on the one of those tables. And on Amazon, they cost €300 a piece. I have two of them. I have to make a review because, well, these guys send it to me for free to make a review. And after a year, I still didn't make the review because, I like to review the stuff I want to review. And when somebody sends something, I think, well, this is not the stuff I would ever buy. I think, not sure, because I didn't test it out yet. Maybe it will surprise me when I test it. Then I say tomorrow. And now it is already 1 year in those boxes. And well, I have to do that. I have to, because those guys send it to me for free. So I can always sell them after the review, you know. I need some space in my house. But okay. I want to make more room because I have here four speakers, three pair of speakers. And I wanted those castles, because I want to sell those castles. I want to sell these Dynaudios, you know, and two of these speakers, because you're still waiting for this, for the video V, the VS test. Which speaker is the best, the Canton Argo RCL or the BMW CM9? So I can tell you that you will be surprised from this test. I already made the video, but you know, I always place the video after I sold something. You understand what I mean? This is how I am. First, I wait till I sold something. There are people, uploaders, who wants to sell their stuff because of their video. You know, I am the other way around. I first make the video, then I sell the stuff, then, or often, the guy who is coming to pick something up, I just in 1 hour before he comes to pick, or 2 hours before, or the evening before, 90% of the time, this is how it goes. I make the video to give me power, because I'm, you know, sometimes I don't want to make a video. I'm lazy to make a video, and then if I know the buyer is coming in my house, I have to make the video quick, because I don't have a second chance. You know, I only buy this stuff for the videos. And when this table is gone, I have more space. I have more space, 90 centimeters extra. So, unfortunately, I like this style. And it is the same style. You see those chrome legs as that table over there. Same style. And now I have a different style, but yeah. I want more space in my house. It's more important at the moment. Okay. I told you that a few times already. In some, maybe you missed it. If you want to have a complete set, you are looking to buy a complete set, and you have to spend 60 or 70% from that amount what you want to spend for speakers. And I don't say this without reason. I was lucky to score these Canton Ergo RCLs, because my first budget was, okay, I want to spend no more as €200 for speakers. And I can tell you that below €200, there are a bunch of nice speakers you can buy for with a very good sound, very pleasant sound. You know, if you can find, if your budget is €1,000, yeah, and or five to six hundred euro, let's say €500 to €600, and you buy speakers from 150, the right ones, you know, then it is the other way around. Then I say, okay, if your budget is €600, you can do with speakers from 200 and a amp from 300, or speakers from 150 and a amp from 350. That would be my advice. But if you want to spend €1,000, then it would be more 50-50. So 500 for the speakers, 500 for the amp. If it is €2,000 what you want to spend for a system, then I would say, okay, 1500 for your, or 1200 to 1500 for your speakers, and 500 for the amp. Yeah, because what I discovered, that below €400, there are only a few amps what will satisfy you. Below €400, yeah, you can find a decent amplifier for 200, decent amplifier, but in the end you will upgrade that amp, because you will see that will be the weak link from your system, you know. So I'm talking about amps from €200, yeah. Speakers, on the other hand, you can find a decent speaker second hand for €150. believe me, my friends. But not a good amp. You cannot find a good amp around 200. Well, good. What is good? If you want a, you know, I have here this Accuphase E206. I have over there the Akai AM93. I have in the box the AM95, the Akai. I had several good sounding amplifiers. I now have another Sansui, the Sansui Sansui 911DG, so with a DAC 1981 amplifier, but it is with Simon. Simon picked it up for me this afternoon. And so I for example, the Accuphase E202. You know, I had some pretty heavy, good sounding, almost perfect sounding amplifiers, my friends. So you will not need more as 500 to 600 euro for a perfect amp. You know, the difference between a 500 euro costing amp and in the shops now a amp from 10,000 euro now in the shops will be very, very small, the difference in sound. You understand? So hear what I say, the difference between a second-hand amp like this Accuphase E206, my Akai over there, AM93, or that a little bit more expensive, I think 800, 900 euro costing Accuphase E202, or different amps I had or receivers around 500 euro. Those amplifiers, you will not have the feeling fast that you have to buy a better amp, because you will not be satisfied after a while. So if you invest 500 euro, let's say between 500 and 700 euro, if you have a little bit more money to spend, 500 to 700 euro for an amp, that will be enough for a almost perfect amp, because I'm not sure those 10,000-20,000 euro costing amps now new in the shop will be so much better. Maybe they will be a little bit better, but you will not miss that quality in sound. That quality from 5 to maybe between 4 and 700 euro second hand, that quality is almost perfect. But if you buy good, if you buy the good stuff, you know, Technics is not my brand. You know, if you, this is even those Technics amplifiers I tested, you know, there are plenty amplifiers. Just watch my videos, what you can score for around 500 euro, what will make you happy. But speakers is something else. If you want to spend 2000 for your system, then I advise, okay, buy a amp from 600, buy speakers from 1400 euro. Because speakers is something else. Speakers, that's why most of my videos goes about speakers. Speakers, the more expensive, often the better, you know. And the sound quality is huge, you know. If you see that Dynaudio over there, yes, and you compare that with that BMW, the sound is huge. If you compare that Dynaudio with my Countons, the sound is huge. But second hand, this Dynaudio, I had a buyer from, he's going to pick it up for 160 euro. But I was not home this evening. I wasn't home, so I have to make a new. I sold this thing for 100. I will sell it for 160 euro for this guy. This is, well, I'm not sure if he's still interested. Maybe not. Maybe because he was the highest bid. So I lose on this set, you know, because I paid 500 euro for the set, the complete set, the speakers and the Arkham Solo. And when I sell this thing for 160, I will lose 160 for the speakers, 150 for the Arkham Solo, 310 euro. So I will lose 190 euro, but I will also lose my gasoline. And the gasoline was about 30 euro. So anyway. But I want to get rid of this stuff, you know. I cannot wait until I finally find somebody who wants to pay 350 euros so I'm even. I don't think that I make a mistake. I often make a mistake. But okay, 160 euro. I paid for those Countons 200 euro. But if you heard the sound difference, it is huge, my friends. So, but the normal price of these cantons is not 200. I was just lucky. Normal price, you will never find them for 200 euro. The normal price is, I think, between 400 and 600 euro. And these speakers make me happy. It's not top of the line, you understand? But they are the best speakers I had. Okay, now I have these BMW CM9s. I thought that these speakers would be better than the Canton Argo RCI. You will see that soon. You know, I will not say it now. You will see which speaker is the best one. Maybe these BMW will defeat my Cantons, and so I can finally sell the Cantons and switch over to these better sounding BMWs. But these BMWs cost a lot of more money. So, yeah, I expect they sounds better, but you will see. Anyway, this video is about the best speaker. Let me switch the camera. The best speaker under 100 euro. And above 100 euro, there are several speakers I would say, well, you can try this, you can try this speaker or this speaker. The best speaker under 100 euro, you can sometimes find for free. Free, my friends. Often in the Netherlands, below 50 euro. Is, believe me, the Technics SB4500. And these speakers, I had the Technics SB4500. I have the Technics SB6000. I had the Technics that with those white, big, I'm not sure, 18-inch woofers. You know, you remember those Technics speakers? So I had a few, but those ones sounds bad with the white, you know, the Technics, I don't remember. The speakers were beautiful, but the sound was bad. And, but below 50 euro, I just saw that. Pick up for free for SB4500 speakers. Just for free, my friends. I think, wow. But it was too far away. And I want to buy these speakers back. I just saw that a few weeks ago, SB500. I bid the guy 30 euro. And then he said, no, it's not enough. And then I thought, okay, let me spend 50 euro because I want this for my living room, for my bedroom, you know. Easy. These speakers, they, you know, if I, people say, yeah, JBL L100, best sounding speakers. But if I close my eyes and I would not know what speaker is spinning, the JBL L100s or those Technics SB4500 or SB5000. Believe me, guys, I would choose for those Technics, and because those JBL L100s or L4312, they sound so hard in my ears, you know, bleedy, you know. The tweeter sound is not nice, that mids are not nice, and those Technics, they sound so smooth. The tweeter do not reach even 20,000 hertz. The tweeter goes, I think, to 17,000, 16,000. But yeah, my ears cannot reach 20,000 hertz. I'm 58 years old, my friends. My ears can only reach 16, 17 at the max. So I will not miss those high-end notes anyway. You understand? So, but the sound is so smooth of these speakers. No, they are not. They are far from studio speakers, you know. But they are so beautiful sounding, really. Especially for jazz. If you like jazz, just try them out. Don't think because they are 50 or 40 euros, these are bad speakers. No, my friend, try them out, buy them. And you will be very satisfied for that price you paid. If your budget is small, or you don't want to spend more as 50 euro for speakers, try out those second-hand Technics SB4500. Not sure about the 4000, but the 4500 and the SB5000. Those speakers you can find below 50 euro. And I sold my set, you know. because my cantos are better, but yeah, you cannot find cantos below 50 euro, you know, let's be honest. So the best speakers I tested, all the speakers I had in my house, the Technics SB4500 were the best, you know, so try to score those speakers. And I already regret this video, because now I know that the price, if let me zoom out. Now I know that the price will goes up. That's normal, because people now will think, well, if those are the good speakers, let's hunt those speakers. And because last week I saw a 4,500 for free. Well, now I'm sure that after this video, I cannot score them anymore for 20 or 30 euro, because the price will go up. Normal, you know. But I have to be honest to you. I have to tell you what I think, you know. And I think this is an interesting video, because not everybody want to spend much money for that system. You understand? Or they want a second system for the bedroom, you know. But those speakers, they are so, they're not suitable for studio. No, not at all. They are very colored. But they sound better than those JBL L100s with a price tag from minimum 500 euro. They ask now for those second-hand speakers. And even if they are ugly, they pay that price. Unbelievable. But in my opinion, my honest opinion, you know, start with those speakers, you know, if your budget is small. And yeah, after a few years you can always change, but believe me, that Technics sound SB4500 or 5000, they're very, very underestimated, my friends, very, very underestimated. I think they will make you happy for a long, long time if you have them in your house. Okay, if you are used to speakers from 1,000 or 500 or 1,000 euro, they probably will not satisfy you. But you know, if you have a low budget, my friends, if you think, well, what the hell, I need a second system for my bedroom, but I don't want to spend too much money, or I'm young, I'm a young guy, I don't have so much money, you know, or I had some problems with money and I need a system, but a cheap one, then those Technics SB's 4500 or 5000, you know, they will make you happy, believe me, my friends. I'm not telling rubbish now, you know, and they are, I don't know, you know, if you place JBL L100 on second-hand market, everybody jumps on them, you know, because JBL L100, that's the speaker to buy. Worthless, my friends. I don't want JBL. I didn't like the sound at all. But those Technics SB4500 or 5000, I didn't heard the 5000, but I think the 5000 is even better than the 4500. They will make you happy. That smooth, especially for jazz, that smooth sound, you know, really, believe me, my friends, I'm not telling you rubbish here, you know. I wish I didn't told you, because now the price will go up and I still want to score an extra set. I want to buy them again, but the 5000, I want to buy the 5000 for around 50 euro is what I want to spend. Well, thanks for watching. And maybe I will make a next video about what is my experience, what is the best, in my experience, what you can buy speakers between 100 and 200 euro. Maybe that will be my next video, or one of my next videos. Anyway, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up. And for now I say, ciao, ciao.